Hello everyone, welcome to my channel for Nursing Exams Learning. We have been discussing many questions related to schizophrenia and some of the other mental health problems for the last 1 week. So this is also a continuation of our question discussion videos, and we'll start with our today's question. Okay, a client recently diagnosed with schizophrenia is brought to the mental health clinic by the identical twin sibling for the first follow-up visit after hospitalization. The client's sibling says to the nurse, "I read that schizophrenia runs in families. I guess I'm doomed." Which is the best response by the nurse? Okay, a client, she is already diagnosed with schizophrenia and she is twins. They are twins, and her twin sibling is the one taking her to clinic for the first follow-up. Upon this first follow-up, her twin, she asked to the nurse, did she also will get this disease, because she read somewhere that this is runs in families, this is like a genetic disease. So which could be the best response that nurse she can give to this client's twin sibling? That is the question. So here there is one keyword, best response. Out of all the options, maybe one or two options are good, but there is one best response that the nurse she can give to this client's twin sibling. We'll see the options. Option one, at the moment, I would worry more about how your sibling is doing. Option two, the odds are about 50% to 50% that you will come down with the disease as well. Option 3, would you like to talk to a healthcare provider about this? Option 4, you are at the risk for the disease. However, there are other factors that contribute to the development of schizophrenia. So, here in the question is specifically connected with the genetic factors or the significance of genetic causative agents of schizophrenia. In the first video of schizophrenia, we have studied that the exact cause of schizophrenia is still unknown. But there are a group of factors or a combination of causes are related to schizophrenia. And in that, we saw some of the things are related to biochemical theories. And during the pregnancy period, if the mother she have any influenza, or if any birth trauma or any epilepsy, then there are some causes like structural brain abnormalities, like reduced size of the brain, then any prenatal factors like faulty neuronal connections. See, these are some of the factors that we studied. And also we studied that the studies show that about 50% chance of developing schizophrenia if one twin develop the disease. So this point we have to connect to this particular question. We have already studied this point. Around 50% of chance of getting the twin sibling if the one develop the disease, because it has some genetic connection. But we could not say that it is entirely a genetic disorder. So if you have this idea, we'll come back to the options and we will see which is the right response the nurse can give it to, or the best response the nurse can give to this client's twin sibling. We'll see. First option, at the moment I would worry more about how your siblings is doing. See, in this scenario, the nurse is giving more concentration to the client. Actually, it's a question made by the client's sibling. So she want to know something about whether the disease she also will get or she will not get. But in this response, the first option response, the nurse is judgmental and she is giving more priority to the client problem, well, how the client is doing and how that is making worry to the client sibling. So this is not an appropriate response. So we can eliminate option one. Then option two, if the odds are about 50% that you will come down with the disease as well. This is not a correct statement, or it's like a blunt non-therapeutic manner of statement, because it does not facilitate just blindly the nurse is saying, okay, there is 50% of chances, and that is not providing an opportunity in front of the client sibling to discuss furthermore, which will be make him more clear idea or more clear information about this particular disease. So that is also we should not consider, because that is not considering more about the client's sibling's feelings. She is really worried whether she will get the disease or not. So the response what we are giving, it should give the priority to the client sibling's concerns and should also give a proper information. So we'll eliminate option two. Then what is the next option? Option three, would you like to talk to a healthcare provider about this? Okay, this one is like the nurse, she don't want to talk much, or she may not be have much knowledge, like just ignoring and passing the information to other, like passing this task of instruction to the doctor. That is not the best thing, I feel. Because this dismisses the sibling's concern and is basically a non-action part of the disease. So out of four, we have eliminated option one, option two, and option three. So what could be our answer? Definitely four will be our answer. Because the nurse, she's giving a response that you are at a risk for the disease. Yeah, that is correct. Because we studied that there is a chance of 50% to get the disease if one of the twin siblings develop the disease. So directly she said, yes, it's correct, you are at the risk of disease. However, that is the point you should give more explanation. That is the point you will get to get more idea about the particular disease, and that will make the client siblings to get more information. However, there are other factors that contribute to the development of schizophrenia. We studied many factors. It's a combination of factors. It's not only because the twin siblings she have disease and the another one also will get. No. That is only 50%, and other 50% is combination of many other factors that also the nurse should educate. So when she will give this particular response, if the client sibling, she will feel comfortable and she might be asked some more questions if she didn't clear, and that will open an opportunity to explore her concerns and get the correct information, and that will make her more comfortable, and she might be little more okay, or her anxiety or her discomfort will decrease. So always in mental health, whenever we are answering a questions, we should have some standard things that as a nurse or as a healthcare professional we should follow. There are some standard answers, so that also we should understand, that also we should keep in our mind. We see in this all other things, maybe we can say, okay, I can pass the information, okay, I will not be the right one, you can discuss with the healthcare provider. I can say, or some might be say in real scenario, it's right. But the best response, and based on the, see, we should imagine that we are in an exam mode. We are not in a real hospital scenario world. In those scenario, it might be some different, especially if we'll consider the policies of different hospitals across the world, and some countries have some different policies. But now we are in an exam mode. We are considering everything in a real exam scenario. So keep that one in your mind and study well. Bye-bye.